I'm going to show you an easy, no-nonsense way to design a sleek app screen in Adobe Illustrator. You can then use this to design the entire app all within Adobe Illustrator. But before we kick off today's video, another way to increase revenue into 2020 is to learn a new skill or a new skill set. And one of the best places to do that is Skillshare. With classes on music, photography, design, freelancing, and much, much more, there's bound to be something there to trigger your creativity and something that can provide vital skills heading into 2020. Learn how you can get Skillshare Premium for 2 months totally for free later in today's video, but let's crack on with the passive income list. And we first need to set up an Illustrator document perfect for app design. And this actually might be one of the most important steps in the entire process. So in Illustrator, come into the mobile sections here, and you're going to find a wide range of dimensions. You need to choose the relevant one for your project. So for example, an Android app might require the latest Samsung model. For this tutorial, let's go for this one here, this Apple screen. Make sure that you have a 72 ppi resolution and the RGB settings activated. For now, one artboard is completely fine, and so let's generate the app design document. If you have the align to pixel grid setting activated, you're probably going to want to turn that off because it's going to cause a whole host of issues in this project. A personal preference of mine is to come into the artboard options menu and then place a centered crosshair. Now I just like to have a good idea of the center of an app screen at all times. I'm going to work on a home screen and I want some imagery and a gradient for my backdrop. You can use a flat design of course, but if you do want some imagery, I suggest coming to Unsplash as they have high res downloads and the content is free for you to use on commercial projects. So I'm going to grab myself a tech related image and then head back to Illustrator. For the background, press M for the rectangle tool. And I personally like to allow my design to bleed over the edges, and this is to make sure the app screen doesn't have any negative spaces along the edges. And again, this is just a personal preference. So I want to add a gradient to my background, and for that I'm going to use the freeform gradient tool. This does allow for a smooth gradient compared to the standard linear and radial gradients. For the gradient itself, I'm going to use three nodes and the top right will be a light source, which I think is going to look really sleek and neat on the final app screen design. It's now time to drag the image onto my app screen. And then coming into the Edit Colors option, I can turn this to a grayscale image. Finally, for this image, we head into the transparency window, and you can play around with different blend modes, but I personally use multiply, and then I'm going to lower the opacity right down close to zero. And then it's just a case of positioning and scaling the image onto the app screen. I'm going to select both the background and the image, and then hold down shift and click the image, so I'm left just selecting the background below. You could always do this in the layers panel or using shortcuts. Now copy the background gradient with Command or Control C, and then paste a duplication with Command or Control F. This time I will come into the layers window, and drag the duplication above to the top of the stack, and then shift click the blue icons to select these two layers. So now with my mouse, I can right click the selection and make a clipping mask. Let's keep rolling with this app design tutorial in Illustrator by locking the background layers with Command or Control 2, and then again grabbing the rectangle tool with M on the keyboard. With Illustrator CC, you can press A for the direct selection tool, and then round off the live corners like so. Or if you don't have CC, you can come into the effects and the round corners menu. Now open up the align menu, and if you don't see it in the top menu bar, just click the drop down menu here. And then make sure to have the align to artboard function chosen, and then align this shape centrally speaking. App design is all about consistency and alignment, and that's one of the main things to take away from today's video. Click and drag the shape whilst holding down the Alt Option key and then release it. Press Command or Control D to repeat this process, leaving you with three shapes. Now I do have some crucial tips relating to typography on app designs. But for now, lower the opacity of the two shapes down to something around 40 to 45, depending on your design and your design taste. Seeing as this is my home screen for the app, I need a command to prompt a login and also a password recovery. So I'm going to make some placeholder text for now, and I'm going to go with white, and I will use the align to artboard function again to make sure it's central on the screen. The font that you want to choose probably should be universal on all computers, so go for something very, very common and also very simple. I personally like Roboto, as it's a really nice sans serif choice. I haven't done it yet, but you want to use the central alignment for the text options in the text menu. So a quick run through the text that I've got here. For the password recovery, I've used a thinner and a thicker font of Roboto, and then again also Roboto for the main button selections. Also take note of the kerning and the weight values in the text box. So now grab the pen tool with P and make sure you have strokes only, and hold down shift to create a line like so. Now I'm going to select the shape line and the text, and then align them together, but not to the artboard, rather to themselves. The text will need to be manually adjusted, however. To make sure that I have an exact copy of the button below, I'm going to remove it and then use the Alt Option key to duplicate this one down below. For the password section, let's put in those circles to hide the password characters. And for this, I'm going to bring a guide along to align the text to the circles. Using the ellipse tool, which is L on the keyboard, and holding down shift, I'm going to make a circle to which I will duplicate with the previous method shown in today's tutorial. And finally, I'm going to align them so they're perfectly aligned together on a horizontal plane. The last step would be to add in a logo or a graphic that represents your home screen for your app, and then to add a person and a lock icon which suggests the login and the password tabs. You can use this home screen to make the other app screens as a kind of template, and you do that by duplicating the artboard over to the right. But do remember that consistency is king when it comes to app design. And making today's video possible is Skillshare. It's the online learning community where millions of creatives come together to learn new skills and to excel their careers or their hobbies into 2020. I'm actually learning how to create 3D and 4D animations through Skillshare. And one of the courses I really am digging right now is one by Gustavo Torres. And even with my busy schedule, I still manage to learn things as most of them are under 60 minutes. So it's really easy to integrate Skillshare into your day-to-day life. And you guys will probably see some tutorials around 3 or 4D animations on this channel when I do perfect and master those skills. It's something I've wanted to learn for a long time, but I've never really had the time to do it. Skillshare is usually a bit under $10 per month, but the first 500 people who sign up using my link down below will get 2 months of the premium version totally for free. So join Skillshare today and learn some new essential skills for your career or your hobby heading into 2020. Also remember, if you want to keep boosting your skills as a graphic designer, do subscribe to my channel for weekly graphic design content. Also, click a video on screen to learn yet more essential skills. But until next time guys, design your future today. Peace.